In the previous video, you created a new project and new user. Let's start off by importing the various different media that you can bring into Autodesk Smoke via the Media Hub. You can follow along by downloading the media via the link in the YouTube description or typing the link displayed below in the internet browser. You can access the Media Hub through the File menu by selecting Import, right-clicking in the Media Library, or by clicking the Media Hub tab at the bottom of the screen. The Media Hub is essentially divided up into two sections. On the left is the media panel containing the media library. This is the Smoke database containing all your source media and sequences. On the right is the file browser where you can access all the locations available to your system. This could include local storage, network connections, or shared networks. If you wish to go to your Mac user folders, click and hold the bookmarks button and choose User Home. This will instantly take you to your common user folders like Desktop, Documents, and Downloads. Clicking the Home icon will always take you back to all the devices visible to your system. To locate media, simply double-click on a device to start navigating through the folders. The file path is displayed at the top of the file browser. If you want to manually enter the location of your media, double-click on the current path field and it will open a keyboard where you can type in the file path. Just press cancel and you can continue to navigate the folders in an intuitive way. Once you have arrived at your desired folder location, you can click the bookmarks pull-down menu and choose to add a new bookmark. This lets you quickly jump back to a favorite location if you are browsing elsewhere on your system. The Media Hub will show your media as clips even before you have imported them into the media library. Supported streaming formats as well as image sequences are displayed as singular clips by default. To view the frames in a clip, you can click and drag the grey bar beneath the thumbnail of a clip to scrub the frames. You can also double-click on any clip to bring up the preview window. The preview window offers you a bit more extra functionality than the standard thumbnail clips in the file browser. For example, you can use the In and Out buttons to set an import range for a specific clip. Let's say you film an hour of footage and you only want to import a few seconds. You set the in frame and the out frame. And when you import the media, Smoke will only bring in what you want. There is also extra information available in the Clip Info and Metadata tabs. The Clip Info tab tells you about the generic details of a source, such as its resolution, format, and timecode. The Metadata tab gives you more specific information relative to the format. For example, you would be able to see all the metadata from footage shot with a RED or ARRI camera. If you need to adjust the metadata setting for any format, you would choose the Format Specific Options tab and you could adjust the various metadata settings for the selected clip. A final word on metadata: set your settings prior to importing. Now, before you import any media, you have to decide if you will let Smoke manage your media. You can opt to import the file in its native file format and keep it where it is, or have Smoke transcode the footage into the intermediate format that you selected when you set up your project. This transcoded footage is copied into the Smoke Managed Media folder that is selected when you installed Smoke. Switch to the General tab, and under Clip Options, you will see that Cache Source Media is turned off. When this function is disabled, you can import the footage into Smoke and work directly with the native source. If Cache Source Media is enabled when you import media, Smoke will background transcode the footage into the intermediate format. You are able to monitor the transcode progress by looking at the message console. You can click on the arrows at the bottom left of your screen to bring up the window. this console is always available, and just click anywhere on the interface to hide it. In this case, the project is set to use ProRes as the intermediate format. You should always be able to start working straight away with the native sources, and Smoke will automatically swap the intermediates as they are processed in the background. I'll turn off Cache Source Media so that I'll be working with the native sources. To import any media into the media library, you can select the clips and press the Import button, or simply drag the clips from the browser to the media library window. Dragging the clips to the library will add them into the Smoke database. If you already have folders inside the library for organization, you can also drag the media to existing folders to keep better organized. You can also import an entire folder, including subfolders and the media they contain. This operation will recreate the same folder structure inside the library to match what is actually on your hard drives. One final tip, you can also import files by dragging and dropping them from the Mac Finder into the library. Next up, dealing with media that contains alpha channels, as well as how to deal with Photoshop files in the Media Hub.